get on the scene like an e-bike machine. Guys, got so many bikes here, so many cool bikes.
These are the scenes, like that song Jimmy Brown sang about, Get on the Scene. He was talking about e-bikes. Nobody knows that. Get on the Scene, which this is the Norco scene. He was talking about these bikes. He was way ahead of his time. People thought he was ahead of his time musically. He was ahead of his time e-bikely as well. Guys, if you're new to this channel, I'm Johnny Nerdout. I convert bikes into e-bikes, and I'm so happy about these two bikes. Let's get right into it. These are called the Norco Scene. These are for a husband and wife that I actually know pretty well, decently know. These are for my mother-in-law and father-in-law. I'm so happy they got them, because now they could ride e-bikes with me and my wife. Okay, let's go right into it. So this is for my mother-in-law. This one's for my father-in-law. This one's a large, this one's a medium. You see they got two different colors, but they're the same bike. Slight differences. This one's got hydraulic disc brakes. This one's got mechanical disc brakes. Both went with a BBS02 motor on it, paired with 52-volt, 6-amp-hour batteries underneath the saddle, in these little saddle bags. Both went with 500C displays. Both got bells on them, so you can tell people to get out of your way. I'm trying to do business here. And both got integrated headlights, so that you can turn them on just by your display. They're run off the battery. You just press and hold the plus button and it turns on, so you could go exploring and tell people to get out of your way even at night. These bikes are so freaking comfortable. As you could probably see by the step-through design, look at this. I'm on this bike, no fuss, no muss. Obviously the seat would have to come down a little bit for me, but like, you don't have to be an older person to appreciate this geometry. Like, I'm a young pup. Look at how high I could jump. And I could still use this. I could get on any bike I want. But riding around on this one, just testing it out, it was like, this thing is so freaking comfortable. Just the upright position, you're sitting upright, your hands are upright. You feel like you're driving in a semi-truck because you're high up above everything. You could see everything. And if you need to, put your feet down. Obviously this saddle needs to come down for me, but it's not going for me. So the seat would, you could just plant your feet real quick, jump off like this. This is a bike that you could literally ride until you die. It sounds morbid, but 50 years you could own this bike and you'll never outgrow it. It's such a solid ride. Norco did such a great design on these bikes, and I love the colors on both of these. We put a gear shift sensor on both of these because it's a mid-drive. You just want to have that. It's like an automatic clutch. When you shift gears, it just cuts power for like half a second, lets the chain switch gears, and then power's on as usual. They both have throttles, which I'm going to pair so that they're tied to the pedal assist, so that if you're in pedal assist 1, the throttle is going to behave just like that. If you're in pedal assist 9, throttle's going to be a lot more powerful. That's what I love about Bafangs. They're programmable. You could change everything to every riding style. And I'm going to tune these motors down a little bit, so you're going to get more range out of these little batteries. These are 52-volt, 6-amp-hour batteries. If you were riding it really hard and fast, unlocked, you'd probably get 10-mile range out of it, maybe. But I'm going to dial them so that they could get 30-mile range out of these things, because they're going to be taking these to state parks, national parks, exploring a lot of them. So they want to be going far. They don't need to be going fast. And these are going to be awesome. All right, let's go do a Johnny Nerdout test. So you can see this thing climbs very well. This is with the stock 44 tooth chainring. Top speed was 34 miles an hour, which is way too fast. So I'm gonna dial this down. Yeah, these things are gonna be great haulers. If you are thinking about doing this bike, just beware, underneath the motor, you will have to grind out a little bit of the underside. There's a little protective piece for the cables that you need to grind off. So this is not for the faint of heart, this install. You definitely need some specialty tools to make this motor fit on here, but it's totally doable. But there's just a little bit of extra work. Highly recommend these bikes though. These are awesome bikes. All right, let me know if you have any questions. And yeah, thanks guys.